Hi everyone, my name is Oksana from the Toronto Public Library. Welcome to Fun with STEM at Home. Today, we will be building a paper airplane launcher. Let's begin with a challenge. Now, only using your wrist, do not move your elbow or your shoulder. Do you think this paper airplane will fly really far when thrown? Let's test it out. Oh no, that didn't fly very far, did it? How can you get a paper airplane to fly really far if you only have a short distance to launch it? Well, today we are going to be engineers and use STEM concepts to build a launcher that will make a paper airplane fly faster and farther. Learning about STEM is really important, because all these concepts are around us. They help us to innovate, explore, and discover. And they are a lot of fun. Parents and caregivers, you are your child's first and best teacher, and the Toronto Public Library is here to support you. Let's talk about some important STEM concepts first. Have you ever watched an airplane when it takes off? It starts off really fast, then lifts off. In order for it to take off, an airplane has to get enough lift to overcome its weight. As it lifts, there is an upward force. This is the air pushing on the plane. However, there is a downward force due to gravity. The faster an airplane goes, the more lift it creates. This is why airport runways are very long. The airplane needs a lot of space to get enough speed to take off. They also need a lot of space to land safely and slow down from how fast it was flying. However, not every runway is long. Some airplane runways are short. For example, aircraft carriers are large ships with runways on them that some airplanes take off of. These runways on the ships are very small and need a type of catapult to help them get some extra energy for the airplane to get extra speed. Remember how we tried to fly our paper airplane just using our wrist? You probably noticed that it did not fly too far or fast. It really needs a boost, like a launcher or catapult, to help it fly. We need to build a launcher that will create enough stored potential energy, which is energy stored by its position, that will give off a lot of kinetic energy, which is motion energy, to make the paper airplane fly really far and fast. In order to do that today, we are going to be engineers. An engineer is a person who designs and builds complex products, machines, systems, or structures. Engineers want to know how and why things work, and they invent, design, and build things that are useful. You are going to test out how far a paper airplane can fly, launched from a short distance, by using materials around your home. The materials that you need are a piece of cardboard, a white piece of paper, colored construction paper to make your own personal airplane, scissors, a ruler, tape, a rubber band, a pencil, a paperclip, some crayons or markers, and some stickers or other material you have for decoration. To begin, we will need to build a basic paper airplane. You will need your white sheet of paper. Start by folding it in half. Fold it back. Take your two ends and fold them in the middle. Now fold it back in the center again. It should look like this. Now fold one side of the wing down. Repeat this on the other side as well. And fold the wing again. And repeat this on the other side. Once done, your paper airplane should look like this. Now, take a paper clip and a piece of tape. Bend the paper clip like this. Tape the paper clip to the nose of the airplane securely. Now, my paper clip is taped securely. Perfect. Now it is time to engineer our launcher. You will need a piece of cardboard, a ruler. We will be using the centimeter side, a pencil, scissors, and a rubber band. When using scissors, safety first and have an adult caregiver supervise or help you. We will be cutting out four pieces for our launcher. Taking your ruler and using the centimeter side, take your pencil and measure out each piece. The measurements for each piece are shown here. Now you have all four pieces cut out, we need to put them together. Take your two side pieces and slide them at the base of your launcher. Now you need to add the stand. Your launcher should look like this. Now we need to loop the rubber band. Take your rubber band and place it in the middle of your launcher. Your launcher should look like this when complete. Now take your paper airplane and place it on your launcher. We are ready to go test it out. Now it is time to test out our paper airplane launcher. Wow, our airplane went super fast and really far. That's because when you pulled the airplane back, the stored energy from the rubber band created so much energy that when it was released, the airplane was able to fly so much faster and farther. You can even try and test out how far your airplane can fly by engineering and designing different types of launchers. What would happen if you built a longer runway or even a shorter one? What if you change the height of your launcher? What would happen? You can test out different designs just like engineers. There's so much you can learn from fun activities like this that can take place anytime, anywhere, and involve everyone. I hope you enjoyed today's Fun with STEM program. Check back soon for more Toronto Public Library STEM programs at home. Bye!